Professor Ssengooba to outline what this whole notion about financing for universal health coverage is and what challenges and how we're going about it. Professor Ssengooba.
So ladies and gentlemen, and thanks Chair, I have a few slides to just position the discussion. And thanks to the keynote speaker, because wherever there is money, governance becomes more thick and the interests become more varied, and of course conflicts become key. So I'm very happy that we are going to be able to discuss financing, but with that backdrop, that wherever there is money, we should also expect serious governance capacity requirements. So next slide, please. Yes, I was given these terms of reference. The fourth is my interpretation to try and answer why we should ask for more government financing, what has been the trend in government financing, and where are the gaps and challenges. The fourth one is what should we be looking at in terms of fitting within the resource envelope, but also how we can get the most of what we get in terms of more funding. You realize that my title has been, if you would go back a little bit to the first slide, is about government as insurance. In Uganda, we are discussing now health insurance, where we want individuals to buy their insurance. But government exists across the globe to actually take the collective risks of its citizens and manage them and ensure that those risks are pooled within the resources of that country. So whenever we talk of insurance, the first insurer of any country is the government. So I'm trying to position this to say, how is the government insurance working now, and how can we try to improve on it, but also how do we use the resources currently made available? Next. And to the third slide, please. Yes, so universal health coverage, just briefly for those who might be new to the area, has these four tenets. The first one is how do we manage the financial burden to the health system, to the health sector, to the government, to the family, to the individual. There is a burden that needs to be managed. And it's not only about what you pay out of pocket as an individual, but also what the country pays out to keep its population healthy. The second one is about increasing sources of good quality. Next. Now, this is to look at what I've just talked about in the first bar as you move towards your left, I believe. The red is what we have, but the rest is what we need if we're to cover those three areas. Maternal, HIV, malaria. And malaria only costed quarter. They have not costed anything else. So if you add those up, our budget need to grow by almost 4%, four times, or fourfold, in order to be able to cover those core interventions. What I'm trying to indicate here is that we have a long journey to make from the current provisions if we are talking about universal coverage. The other way is saying move the green that we are seeing in the other graph from bottom all the way to 100%. We really need to invest out if we were to cover the entire area. See, as I summarize this, we can go through, please click faster so that I don't talk a lot. What can we do in order to optimize what we have next? So if we were to invest in contraception, we can reduce a lot of pregnancies which are accidental. Right now, there are about 37% pregnancies that happen without a plan. Meaning that if people had effective contraception, that burden could be reduced. But we need to invest in the contraception to be effective, to be accepted, to be safe. And that is the amount of money we need if we are to reduce the burden of children and, of course, pregnancies, especially the unintended one. Next. Medicines is a big area. Out-of-pocket expenditures are almost driven by lack of medicines. The video you saw, many experiences in the room as will be shared, medicines sometimes are delivered in big boxes. But many times the boxes become empty in a week. Next slide. And this is why. This is a small experiment I carried out at home. There are 10 tablets of deworming tablets for my family. And you can see the volume of paper and the printed materials from which those tablets came out. You can imagine this was probably manufactured in India or China. It was shipped. There was a lot of shipping of air and printed paper and a lot of blister packs. And if you ask me how much money have we spent on that medicine versus printed material, blister packs, shipment, we are wasting a lot of our money in non-essential pieces in this area of medicine. And go back to the question of institutional capture. Who is capturing our money? The printers, the packaging, the shipping. We are getting few medicines for even the little money we have. Next. Health workers. We have a lot of concerns right now about absenteeism. I have a lot of personal opinions about this. So, but to summarize, we have few health workers. We expect them to work 24 hours, even against the law. They should not have weekends, should not have leave, should literally be there. The whole question of absenteeism assumes presenteeism. And a health worker is not entitled like any other, and NGOs and media people have made this assumption without interrogating it. Next slide, just to explain why. This is the projection of the health workers we should have, the top blue. But the lower blue is what we have chosen to put in the policy. And right now, we are not even achieving 100% of that. Meaning that the gap of what we should have versus what is available is bigger than the gap between those two lines. What should that mean? That by policy we've allowed absenteeism. But some people prefer to put this absenteeism on some face, of a midwife, or a doctor, somebody who was not there. But remember, when you are sick and you turn up, also people have legal obligation to be off duty. Health workers are supposed to work 8 hours. Government is supposed to provide health workers for 24 hour, meaning 3 shifts of 8 hours a day. Next. So we need to spend money to pay those workers. We need to prevent services so that people don't get sick. And this is an example of what is being done well. And the more we can go to the communities and help prevent diseases, the better we do. But how much are we financing? Most of these are kind of camps which are offshore. Usually Red Cross and NGOs, they do them like, by the way, they are not institutionalized. Next. Malaria is the biggest burden on the budget. There are effective interventions. This demonstrates how doing spraying for 2 years in this area in northern Uganda was able to reduce malaria almost by half, which would save us a lot of money, but all the 20 districts right now are receiving it. Out of 130 districts. Government doesn't want to scale this up. Next, as I wind up, Chair, they say this is very expensive, but I can see that UPDF, as in the picture, has a lot of men and women who are not deployed. There's a lot of youth who are not employed. There are a lot of volunteers who can do this thing for free. With little training, IRS, government says is the most expensive, but actually the cheapest, because even at community level, there's free labor. The medicines are not that expensive. The benefit to the budget in terms of reducing consumption of medicines is big, meaning that if we are able to save some money from Kawatema and put it here, we will do well. But unfortunately, every time we ask for IRS or the global fund, that's the first one they cut out. The only one to pay, what next? So, insurance is a big discussion, we should have it, but I picked some light humor for you there. Those who can have insurance have the priest to pray for the insurance. because insurance always needs prayers. And the other one is saying, you know, insurance is like a doctor's gown, doesn't cover all the parts. Next. I think if we are to be effective in this area, and this is my last time, we really have to lead this. This was a French public health doctor who, after working in West Africa, went back to try and advocate for better health and influencing government policy and financing, particularly the insurance aspect of government is really vital for us to achieve coverage. So I'll stop here.